Hello everyone, and welcome to the Modern Java course. Up until now, we covered features that are mostly unique to Manifold. Today, we will talk about Manifold Properties support, which is very similar to the core feature of Lombok. I think this demonstrates the core philosophical differences between these two projects. Before I proceed, as usual, the code for this and the other videos in this series is available on my GitHub page. So check out this project, start it, and follow me on GitHub. I mentioned this when we first discussed Manifold. I love Lombok, and I think it's great. But Manifold has its own advantages. I think this is best illustrated in this table. Lombok is a bit long in the tooth by now. Many of its features were designed for old versions of Java and are no longer applicable. Manifold is immature with limited integrations and growing pains. This is very obvious with the limited IDE support in Manifold. It's also obvious with the fact that we can convert Lombok code to plain Java sources, but can't do the same for Manifold. However, Manifold is very extensible and pluggable with a well-thought-out architecture. This made Manifold grow into an extensive project that is far more ambitious than Lombok. You might recall this code from my Lombok video. There's a lot more to it, and I won't cover everything. This is how you write getters and setters in Lombok. Lombok, in essence, is a boilerplate remover in this case. We use an annotation as a substitute to writing the getters and setters, but they are still there. When we want to access the field number from outside the class, we have to invoke a setNumber method, which seems odd. We never wrote that method. It does make sense though, as this remains consistent with non-Lombok classes, so I understand exactly why Lombok did that. Still, this is part of the reason people have a problem with Lombok. It feels like a band-aid. Before I proceed, a small warning. Properties in Manifold are marked as experimental. This mostly means that they are complicated and still under development. Everything I'll discuss today should be stable, though, and probably won't change. Properties aren't a new concept. In fact, there were talks about adding this change to Java a couple of decades ago, but we couldn't agree on a direction. This approach taken by Manifold is very similar to the one taken by other languages such as C#, Kotlin, and pretty much any other language. On the left-hand side, you can see the Manifold equivalent of this Lombok code, sort of equivalent. These two approaches seem similar, but are very different conceptually. First off, notice that Manifold has no equivalent of a class-level setting. A property is an individual field. It never applies to an entire class. Manifold might offer something similar to the data annotation in the future, but at the moment, that just doesn't exist. Also notice I didn't bother with the private keyword. When we define a property, the default is to make the field private and accesses public. We can customize this using annotations just like we can in Lombok. This is where things take a different turn. We can invoke setNumber or getNumber as if we're accessing the number field. With Manifold, this works consistently and hides that behavior, not just for properties, but for a regular setters and getters too. I can access calendar.getInstance as calendar.instance. Similarly, I can get the time from that instance using time in millis, which translates to the get time in millis call. Notice that in this case, access was made to a static method and to an instance method. This is all very consistent, and it's the way things work in languages such as Kotlin. This sort of syntax even works with Java records, although it's probably not a huge difference there. Just like we can customize an individual property, in Lombok we can do the same thing with manifold. We can use the val for read-only parameter, which will only generate a getter. The behavior of this property is similar to a final field since it isn't writable. We can use set for a write-only parameter. In an argument to any of those, we can pass scoping preferences which only apply to the generated method. If I set a property to final, it won't apply to the field. This means the generated setter and getter method will be marked as final. The field won't. Notice that in the case of static, all the elements will be marked as static, the setter, getter, and field. Since number is a read-only property, here we can't assign a value to it. Since str is a write-only property, we can't print from it. Lines that do these things won't compile. The reason we have properties instead of fields is encapsulation. It seems like this is lost here, but it isn't. If I write a setter or a getter, it replaces the method generated by manifold. If I implement set number, it will be smart enough to treat access to the number field as access to the field and not the setter. I can implement the method any way I want, and all the code will behave exactly the same. Another popular feature of Lombok is the sneaky throws annotation that allows us to throw a checked exception without declaring or catching them. Manifold has something similar, but it is global, unlike Lombok. By adding a block of boilerplate to the POM file, we can disable checked exceptions in Java, make them act like runtime exceptions everywhere. Personally, I love checked exceptions, but I get where this is coming from. With this, let's go back to a deeper comparison between Lombok and Manifold. Lombok has the data and value annotation. I hope data will make it to Manifold eventually, but right now it isn't there. There is no Manifold annotation that generates equals, hash code, or two string methods. This is indeed sorely missing. The same is true for constructors. Required args constructor is especially useful for Spring Boot injection. Manifold has no support for the builder pattern built into Lombok. This is again a shame. Loggers are also a great feature of Lombok. Both are missing the Kotlin dot question mark syntax that lets us set a value and fail gracefully if a property along the way is null. But Manifold is the only one where this matters, since it has the dot notation. It is also has smarter scoping logic, as it uses property keywords for the setter and getter, not for the field. Its code makes more sense. Like all things, this comes down to old versus new. I like Lombok, but it's showing its age. Manifold is showing its age as well, but from the other direction. I'm not sure which one I will pick for the next project I have going. I will probably go with Manifold, mostly because of the other features it brings to the table. If you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.